I'm Teresa Strasser, and you're on the list. One and done, it's a phrase all too familiar to Reds fans. Janelle Walton joins the conversation about the big game that broke hearts around Cincinnati.
Number one, fade to black. That's how the Enquirer summed up the season-ending implosion. With the Reds losing their last six games, the end was ugly. Now, too, is the backlash. Disappointed fans took to social media, like Keith Fulmer, who posted on the Reds' Facebook page, "You can't win one for the fans when it counts." Phillips and Votto stepped up to the plate to accept blame.
The city of Cincinnati really deserves better.
I felt like I made a lot of mistakes.
There are six long months to forgive and forget, so remember these words.
There's no crying in baseball!
Number two, beer lobbyist. That's what beer fans might become once they hear the government shutdown could impact their beer consumption. It turns out beer labels are approved for use by the Tax and Trade Bureau. Listerman Brewery has beer labels waiting for the okay.
They're very, very picky about the wording on the labels. First of all, you have to have the government warning. Pregnant women, it can't have anything about some health benefit. If it's in a funny language, they want it translated.
Number three, city council Twitter rant. It's sort of like the Jimmy Kimmel, Kanye West Twitter feud, but without a spoof video.
If I see opportunity, I'm gonna go for it.
Cincinnati City Council candidates Angela Beeman and Mike Morosky take their differences over the controversial streetcar project to Twitter. Mike tweets, "Let me get this straight. Only poor people use public transit? That's a bit essentialist for my taste." Angela responds, "Public transit is for individuals who need help and cannot afford a car, not privileged ones who want to hang out and have a drink." You can follow the candidates' streetcar showdown by going to @BeemanForCouncil and Mike Morosky. Now you're caught up in Clued In Around Cincinnati. I'm Janelle Walton.